appreciate it.
Chair over there.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mike, how are you?
It may still be warm from the President of Columbia.
I heard your statement on the House Speaker of Central America. I certainly agree. It's a good move.
Well, yeah, I think they've got a chance with this, although
they're not responsible.
I was going to say, I don't know how free the government of Nicaragua is to move. I think they may have to take orders at this point.
Probably do. They're becoming the Ortega brothers. I always figured were Soviet agents.
Well, is Betancourt supportive
of what we're doing?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Going to go out and say so?
Matter of fact, he's going to see Ortega.
That's good. But I think the Ortega brothers are trained Soviet agents. How do you deal with that?
Well, you know, this whole thing, the heroism now attributed to Sandini, I guess was his name, for which the Sandinistas are named. But if you look back, he was a practicing communist.
I didn't know that.
I don't know whether you've ever taken this same kind of a picture or not, but it's the first time in my life that I've ever done this, and I'll bet it's the first time in your life that you've ever been in a receiving end.
You betcha.
But I am presenting to the Secretary of the Treasury a check for $1 million from our inaugural fund, which we are turning over to the Treasury Department as a gift.
Thank you, Mr. President. Appreciate that very much. It is indeed the first time I've ever received a check for $1 million. I think the deficit reduction fund would be a good use for this.
I'm in favor.
Let's see the check. Here we go.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Great.
I'm Frank Hodsell. Nice.
Hello, Mr. President. How are you, sir? It's a great pleasure for me to share one of these with you.
I don't know. This is something almost, you might say, what I did all the time I was in Hollywood. I many times gave them out. No one ever gave one to me. But
well, yes,
no,
I was the actor of this, but I think you're the director. It was a great honor. For Best Picture.
Yes. Well,
I thought you'd be pleased because, you know, it's your endowment. I think we got it during your period as president, and I think that's a tribute to the whole administration. So
well,
I think
I'm very proud of all of you.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. I appreciate
all right.
it. Also, looking forward to the National Medal of Arts, which you'll be giving out in April. So I'm looking forward to that as well. So thank you very much, sir. Sure appreciate it. Thank you.
Right.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
And we just start this with the talk.
Yeah.
This is John Swan, the Premier.
Yes, hello there.
Good to see you again.
See you again. It's been a couple of years now.
That's right. 1982. It's been a couple of years. You're doing a fine job. Mario,
well, thank you very much.
Keep track of the
overtime. Well, pleased to see you, and my daughter Maureen speaks very highly of
The honor of being in her presence last night.
Oh.
Rather enjoyed it together with Mrs. Kilpatrick.
Yeah.
Doing an honor to her last night.
But listen, we also appreciate your position during the Grenada affair and your support of that.
You're great allies, and we want you to let you know.
I understand you've been up in the hill about the, or are going up there, about the convention tax.
I've been up there and had an opportunity to speak with the chairman, Senator Packwood, Rostenkowski.
We want to help if we can. I'd like to see that done.
I appreciate all the help that you've been giving us, and I feel confident that your support and help, which I know you stand behind it, something could possibly happen.
All right.
I really appreciate the opportunity of seeing you again, and good. I wish you well.
Well, good to see you, and thank you.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Take care. Thank you.
Great. Bye. Hi, how are you?
Good to see you.
Well, it's good to see you.
Yeah, it's been a long time. Last time I was with you, I was in shorts.
Ready to run.
Yes, and you did have a...
Mr. President, Bill Key. Nice to meet you, sir.
I know you must be very proud.
Thank you.
Mrs. McCannell.
Nice to see you.
President Lane Adams. And John Ellison. John sends greetings to you.
Thank you.
President, Chairman of the Board, Bob Gatter, and Mrs. Gatter, you.
Good to see you. Nice to see you. Good to see you. Well, Apple, I guess you know how everyone in this country feels about what you did. And I understand that Boston College, it was varsity lacrosse. You also were a snow skier.
Yeah.
And swimming, and that's the only one I could find in relationship with. That was one of my sports.
Oh, yeah, swimming also. Yeah, training for the Ironman in Hawaii. The Big Ironman, have you ever heard of the Big Ironman triathlon in Hawaii? Oh. You swim 2.5 miles, cycle 112, and run a marathon back to back.
And I know that you've already been in and completed a triathlon where out of 500 athletes, you were the only one that was an athlete.
Yeah, that's correct. You got a good memory there.
You've done something that I think is a great service to the mankind and humanity, and your courage has been a beacon to all of us.
Well, I think you yourself represent the word courage and being shot and overcoming that. And I think people should really recognize that as well. Demonstrate courage in a way, and you sure represent it in a unique fashion.
Well, thank you for that. But now, one thing I want to ask. I understand that I know all about your finishing in California,
of course,
because I called you here about that.
Yeah.
But I understand that the hardest was Southern New Mexico, the Continental Divide.
Western New Mexico, we were up about 8,000 feet, it's 14 inches of snow, and the wind was about 40 miles an hour, and you're out there in the open. Sometimes you ask yourself, why am I out here doing this?
But I never thought of it in the connection with the snow and the season, of course.
Yeah,
I was thinking of it just the way it would be.
Yeah, you ran into a lot of snow. People mistake New Mexico for summer, they have winter too.
No, also that same weather, that altitude.
Oh, yeah, it's tough. But we got through it, and we helped out a lot of people. Raised a lot of awareness for the American Cancer Society, which was very instrumental in my run. Thanks to them, I was able to accomplish it.
Well, they have something of thanks for you. This is the American Cancer Society Award for your personal courage in battle against cancer, for giving all Americans hope, inspiration, and pride by a successful run across America.
That's great. Well, thank you very much, Mr. President. Thank you for having us here.
Thank all of them.
From one great runner to another.
That's right.
You had a pretty good race last November.
Yes.
Is Mrs. Reagan out in California?
She left this morning.
Yes. I give her my best.
Well, I sure will.
I'll never forget that.
We left California.
Oh, well. We do too,
and it was
tomorrow
nice to,
I will join her.
Nice to hear your voice over the loudspeaker in the park.
Yeah, in the park. And my friends threw me in the water after that.
They did?
I got a drinking, yes. the only thing they could do for me.
I just thank you for looking at the weather, man. I was wishing that it would rain last week, so it would be sure not be raining. But we ought to be about toward the end of the winter season in California now.
Yeah.
Unless they just say the last one.
Yeah, I just came from the slopes of Colorado. Yeah, the weather. The sun's tough out there. Going back out there now.
So it was a great thing.
Okay.
We're all grateful to you.
Yeah, thank you again. Okay. Best of luck. Good to see you soon.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. We were here last year. I said we wanted to come back this year, but we wanted you here.
Thank you.
Thanks for that.
Well,
have a wonderful time.
Surgeon. Stick the sash for 11.
President.
Nice to meet you. And when Mrs. Thatcher was here, she mentioned in her toast that this year was the bicentenary, not just of Anglo-American relations, but also of the establishment of a venerable institution, which is my newspaper, the London Times. Well, and in honor of that event, I would just like to make a small presentation. This is our office over 100 years ago, and I'm afraid it doesn't look like that anymore, because it's all glass and steel and high technology. And in those days, people sat by fires and broke off each evening for dinner. But times have progressed.
Well, so thank you very much. I'm very pleased to have you.
Thank you very much for this opportunity of meeting with you.
I think they want us to, for a picture, seated there as if... that's right. Yes.
Could I take this opportunity just to ask you, I know you can't say anything about the date or time or agreement of a summit, but if a summit were to take place with Mr. Gorbachev, would you regard this as a turning point in American and Soviet relations?
Well, I don't know whether you could say that, because there have been summit meetings before. I would look on it as an opportunity to hopefully clear the air and express our desire to have a relationship that would eliminate this great threat that seems to hang over the world. And if in any way it could lead to help in the negotiations that are going on in Geneva. So, and very frankly, I'd like to speak to him also about some things like the recent tragedy with our officer there in Germany. Those things are so senseless. There's no need for them. But I don't know that you could see it as a turning point. After all, he has been, for 4 years, a member of the Politburo, 14 years a member of the Party Council. So we know that the government really is a collective of that Politburo. That's the ultimate authority. So I can't see that some of speculated that there would be a great change of direction. It would only come about if that was the desire of that same Politburo.
Yes, I was going to say, given the nature of the Soviet system, how far can relations improve between the two nations?
They can improve if we can show them that it would be to their material advantage as well as someone else's. I think about the Geneva talks that way right now. It's the first time in about 50 years, more than 20 arms negotiations and talks with them going between World War II and the present, that it is really the first time that they sit down faced with the possibility that either we join together in reducing arms, or they engage us in an arms race, which they know they can't win.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you very much indeed. And I hope you have a very pleasant Easter in California.
Well, same to you.
Thank you very much.
Hello, Mr. President.
Well, I know you got away before we could do
that's
this.
That's what happened. You were busy last summer campaigning.
Well, let you and I go in front of the fireplace for a picture, and then you will join us.
All right.
Good. This side hand? It doesn't matter. Thank you, sir.
All right. And if anyone sees the picture and asks you, how did I get the bloodshot eye? Won't you come in now? I'm very self-conscious about it. They tell me I broke a little blood vessel in my
eye. We were reading about that in the paper, Mr. President. I hope it's not any problem for you.
Thank you. I'm kind of glad they put that in the paper. I wouldn't want people to think I was out of the town all night.
Well, we just have the Vice President in the moment for a visit.
Yes.
Which I think he enjoyed, and Mrs. Bush very much. So this is quite a month for us.
Yes, now you again. Wonderful.
Pleased to see you, and thank you for what you're doing.
Good, thanks so much.
Thank you very much.
All right. Oh, one more here. that you won't forget us.
Oh, all right. That's true. Thank you.
Well, all right. Good luck.
Thanks.
Get a picture over here.
I just joined the staff in the last couple of months, actually. Detailed from the State Department.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Let me smile.
Go ahead.
Hello, folks. Hello, President.
Richard. I understand that.
Just one.
I waited for you.
Mr. President. Well, did our Air Force treat you all right?
Perfectly well.
Very good indeed. Well, earlier today we heard about this. Someone said that you guessed God was looking out for all of us.
Yes.
Well, please, sit down.
Thank you, Mr. President.
I want to present this to you. This is the FDN pin. Many of our men wear that. As many pins as we can get, we give to them and they wear it.
Well, thank you very much.
I want you to have it.
But have you told them of the proposal yet?
We've just been going over it, yes, sir.
Well, we hope it can make some impression on our congressman up there. We're having some problems with him, as you know, and I don't understand it. Now that the record and the background of all three of you, how they can fail to see the Sandinista government for what it really is, I don't understand.
Your proposal certainly puts the Sandinistas on the corner. We'll see what happens.
What?
Puts the Sandinistas on the corner.
On the spot.
Yes. On the spot.
Well, we hope so. We'll do our best. Well, I feel I'm interrupting the meeting here because I know I have to go on, but just again, God bless you and thank you for being here.
Thank you, Mr. President.
We know what you've done and what you're doing.
And we'll keep on. And I know we'll continue to count on your support.
Yes, you can. Yes.
Pete, have you got a good picture?
All right.
Gracias, Presidente.
Well,
yeah,
that's
great.
All right.
I'm going to meet Don Regan, Alfonso Robello.